ChargerLAB has taken apart the Lenovo C135 GaN charger, which supports 135 watts charging for its new laptops and is also a 100 watts fast charger that comes with an original cable with a square connector. Today, we'll take apart this cable to see how is it. The black cable is thick and soft. Both connectors are frosted, and the USB-C connector is printed with the Legion logo. The USB-C connector has 12 pins inside. The square connector is yellow plastic inside, and the pins are gilded. The length of the cable is 1.52 meters. The diameter is about 4.81 millimeters. The weight is about 64.3 grams. The ChargerLAB Power ZKM002C shows it adopts an eMarker chip and supports Lenovo 135 watts charging. Now, let's see what's inside. There are 4 power wires, of which 2 are red and positive and 2 are black and negative. Cut the outer skin, there are the shielding mesh and the shielding aluminum foil. Inside the aluminum foil are the power wires and the cotton threads. This cable serves only as the power supply. The cotton threads are to provide lubrication and reduce hardness. The 2 red positive wires are the tinned copper wires with tensile fibers. The 2 black negative wires are the same. Now, let's take apart the USB-C connector. Use a cutter to cut the outer injection molding. The terminals are fixed by soldering steel sleeve. The USB-C connector is soldered with steel sleeve, solid and durable. Remove the steel sleeves. The connector is internally filled with hot rubber for insulating and fixing. The other side is the same. The small PCB board is wrapped and insulated with high temperature tape. Remove the hard rubber and the small PCB board is wrapped with yellow tape. A 6-pin chip is soldered on the side of the PCB. 3 chips are soldered on the back side. Remove the yellow tape and we can see the 6-pin chip. The front and back of the PCB are soldered with positive and negative wires for power supply. The positive and negative wires are fixed by adhesive and soldering dots. The power input adopts the LOWPOWERSEMI LP3993 in a SOT233 package. It's a 200 mA voltage regulator with an input voltage of up to 28 volts and marked with 2 watts to indicate an output voltage of 3.3 volts. The USB-C controller adopts the Hynetek HUSB238 for input voltage. It's a USB PD sync controller that has been certified by USB IF PD 3.0 with TID number of 3666. The eMarker chip inside the terminal is from Hynetek HUSB332A and marked with 332A. It's a USB Type-C eMarker chip that supports USB Type-C 2.0, USB PD 3.0, USB 4 specification, Thunderbolt 3 specification, and the USB PD 3.1 EPR. It has been certified by the USB IF with a TID number of 4324. Then, remove the shell of the USB terminal. The positive and negative joints are widened and gilded, which is not easy to oxidize. Finally, let's take apart the square connector. The connector is wrapped with injection molding and filled with hard rubber. Remove the hard rubber. The black wire is connected to the shell and the red wire is connected to the inside. The IP pin is connected to the negative terminal through a resistor for the laptop to identify the power supply. From this side, we can clearly see the positive and negative soldering dots. The negative terminal of the power supply is connected to the metal shell, and the 1 kilo ohm resistor is connected between the negative terminal and the IP pin. This original cable with a USB-C to 135 watt square connector of Lenovo Legion 135 watt GaN charger can turn on the 135 watt output. It adopts an eMarker chip from Hynetek and supports Lenovo 135 watt fast charging. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!